Welcome back to the West Country at Westminster, where we're discussing how much people care about politics, or not, as the case may be. I'm joined now by two younger people who are motivated enough to make a difference within their own communities. Orla McKeon-Carter is campaigning to get rid of plastic bags in Plymouth, and Martin Ritchings from Cheddar is involved in a project to raise funds and build a skate park for the young people where he lives. Both are involved in our ITV Fixers scheme, which is supporting young people between the ages of 16 and 25 to take action on any issue that they feel strongly about. Welcome to both of you. What progress on the skate park, Martin?
We've got some money together. I'm doing another event to raise some more money in April, on April 11th, actually. It's a BMX jam and then a club night afterwards to try and raise some more money. We're trying to get charity status. I'm in a group called the Cheddar LAT.
Yeah.
We're going to get charity status so we can apply for grants from governments and things.
Did any of the formal politicians, as it were, be they local councillors or be they MPs, take a part in this, or did you consider them
Yeah, there's
relevant?
An MP called Mary Buxton who's actually part of the Cheddar LAT. I'm not really sure what side she's on.
Did that matter? I mean, fascinating point you raise. It didn't matter whether she was red, orange or blue.
No, well, she's helping out, so that's what counts, really. I don't know what side she's going from, but it seems to be working out well.
Yeah. And Orla, when you looked at it, you're still at school, so you've got that to be worrying about, GCSEs and the rest of it, like so many people. But first of all, what motivated you to want to take on the plastic bag in Plymouth?
Well, of course, it was quite a big issue anyway, but a kind of nationwide issue, but I really felt strongly about it myself. And even in Plymouth, it's quite a major issue for me because walking around streets or beaches, you know, they're everywhere, and especially in the shops. So I just felt that the issue really needed to be addressed.
And of course, it has been done already in another community.
Yes.
But I'll put the same point to you as I put to Martin. Did you immediately think, right, I must get the local council on board, I must particularly get members of parliament in Plymouth on board? Or did you think, no, this is me and my mates and the people we know?
Well, I thought that at first it was me and my friends because we all had the enthusiasm to do it. But of course, getting MPs and ITV Fixers really helped because it kind of got the message out there. And of course, Plymouth saw, well, the South West saw the ITV Fixers campaign that we had. So hopefully I got the message out there. And also Linda Gilroy contacted me saying congratulations on the plastic bag fix. So it shows that the message is actually getting out there and people are more aware of the problem.
Sure. Now, you went to college and then you decided to move on and do other things to set up your clothing firm as well as do this skate park thing.
Yep.
But just cast your mind back. You've decided to do this about the skate park. What did your mates, men and women generally, think about politics, whether it was something that they wanted to get involved in, whether it was relevant to their lives?
None of my friends really talk about politics, really. That's what I say. It's not really part of my everyday life. Going to the pub is, but not talking about politics and who's saying what, and none of that's really part of my life.
And is that how you'd like it to remain? Or do you think that we've got three MPs we're just chatting to and we'll chat to them again in a moment, that there is anything that they could do that would get you back on board?
Make it a bit less boring. I don't know what they talk about. After about 5 seconds, I just switch off and get a bit bored about it.
You see, I think that's absolutely fascinating. I'll come back to you on that, Orla, because us boring commentators as well looking at it would say, for example, take your plastic bag campaign. The environment is supposed to be one of the defining issues of politics at the moment, with them all vying for your votes and what have you. But you've got comments from politicians saying, well done you, but you did it yourself. Do you share his apathy, his cynicism about politics?
Well, I think some politics is good, of course, because at GCSE level now, I don't really have much knowledge of politics because it's not a subject that's really taught at school. And I think maybe that's part of the problem. People don't know enough about, it's not that they don't care, it's that they don't know enough about politics, maybe. And also the problems, as some of the MPs said, may not directly relate to us. And what it needs to be is young people need to actually care about the problems, and the problems need to relate to them.
Yeah. Would you share finally that thought that some of your mates were tricked off because they weren't talking about the right stuff?
Yeah.
And what, in a word, would you like them to be talking about?
Off the top of my head, I can't say. I can't think, really.
Well, don't worry, because I will put that exactly as you've put it, to them in just a moment. So thanks there to Orla and to Martin for coming on, and of course good luck to them with all of their fixing. So does politics get you going, or if not, why not? And if you ran the country, what would you like to get people voting for? We set up our own seat of power on the streets of Bristol to see what you think.